let's discuss an example on collision. So what we have here is this ball, which weighs 0.1 kilograms and it's moving with a velocity of 10 meters per second. It collides with the ball, which is stationary and has mass of 0.2 kilograms. They both combine together and form one ball and start moving in the same direction as the original ball. Let's call this x direction. So what is the final velocity of this bigger ball and how much energy is lost in the collision? Okay, so first of all, is it an elastic collision or an inelastic collision? Well, it's an inelastic collision. You see that whenever this joining process happens, we expect that things will lose energy, the system will lose energy to heat in form of heat and sound. So whenever two balls combine together or something lodges in itself into something, then it's an elastic collision for sure. So here we have to find the velocity and also the energy lost in the collision. So let's begin. So again, it's just a problem of conservation of momentum. You see, momentum is going to remain conserved anyway. So what is the initial momentum of the system? Well, it is 0.1 multiplied by 10. It's in the x direction, so it's positive. And this is 1 kilogram meters per second. And all the momentum is coming only from this mass. This mass is no momentum. How about the how about the final momentum? The final momentum is going to be 0.3 multiplied by v, which is 0.3 v, and we know that 1 should be equal to 0.3 v, right? And that gives us v equals 10 over 3 meters per second. Now so we have the velocity. Now how can we find the energy lost? Well, energy loss can simply be defined by finding this value. E initial minus E final is the energy that is lost. What is initial? Well, E initial is half 0.1 V square. All the energy is kinetic energy because that's what it is. Minus half multiplied by 0.3 multiplied by 10 over 3 squared. Let's see if we can solve this. If we take 0.1 or let's say 1 over 20 outside, we are left with 100 minus 100 over 3. And that is 1 over 20 multiplied by 200 over 3, and this is 10 over 3 joules. So that is the amount of energy we lose in this collision, and we'll discuss more examples in coming lectures.